Today I launched with UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, WHO Director General Dr. Tedros, and Under Secretary General for Humanitarian Affairs Mark Lowcock, a humanitarian response plan for COVID-19. This is a joint funding appeal asking donors to help us help those most in need. For us at UNICEF, this appeal is critical because of the impact COVID has on children. Children are the hidden victims of this pandemic. We're worried that not all of them have access to water and soap. You all know that washing hands with soap is critical in the fight against COVID-19. But did you know that 40% of the world's population, or 3 billion people, do not have a place at home to wash their hands? We're worried about children's education. And here is another scary fact. More than 80% of the world's school population is out of school because schools are closed in 156 countries. Most of these students will probably go back to school when things get better. However, we know from experience that for vulnerable children, the longer they stay away from school, the less likely they are to return. We're also worried about their health. We don't want children to miss out on important vaccinations because we don't want to see other diseases spread out. Mental health is very important in these times. Children are missing out on some of the best moments of their young lives, chatting with friends, participating in class, and enjoying sports. We know that this increases anxiety and can cause changes in behavior. I know that with unity and more support, we can together shore up support for the more vulnerable children and help countries with weaker healthcare systems. So, thank you for supporting UNICEF. Remember to check unicef.org/coronavirus. For ways to help and for tips on how to keep safe and stay informed.